What's happening? It's Yannick Guzdala. It's the Yannick Guzdala podcast. You find me here. It's what time is it? 8:52 p.m. The day, as far as domesticity, is kind of over. All the things are where they need to be, including the little one in her bed. Hopefully she's going to stay asleep long enough for me to get accomplished what I want to do this evening and what I want to let you inside on in this episode of the podcast. I'm going to spend an hour practicing pretty much straight. I'm going to talk very little. I'm going to take breaks here and there, maybe every 10 or 15 minutes. There'll either be four or five breaks throughout the hour, just briefly. Maybe I'll talk then. But I want to run down exactly what I get into at this moment. When I get to what is now today, my third practice session of the day. I got practice in early, I got practice in the middle of the day, and here I am sneaking in another hour. And the most important part of it to me, what I would love for you to pay attention to, sure, not a single person listening is going to make it all the way to the end. I will not be offended. It's just somebody practicing incessantly. But if you can make it 10 minutes in, or even 20 minutes, maybe the first two chunks, think to yourself how long those 10 or 20 minutes feels, and hopefully, fingers crossed, how much I'm actually getting done in that time, and what one is able to accomplish in such a short space of time that actually feels like an eternity. I'm really just going to be working on the melody to this blues for the first 10 minutes to kind of warm up again, like re-warm up. I'm feeling pretty good today. As I said, I got maybe 2 hours or 2.5 hours over the last two sessions earlier on today, and trying to make it up to three and a half, something like that, for the total for today, which is not bad considering everything else that's going on. I'm sure there are tons of people out there with responsibilities and kids and maybe jobs that have nothing to do with music, but you still want to practice. Well, here it is. Here's an hour. Here's my hour this evening. What are we? I'm not sure when this podcast is coming out, but I'm recording it Wednesday, December 28th. And this is kind of what I'm getting into and what I generally get into when I have this kind of time to practice. I'm playing this melody, a Pamathini melody called Soul Cowboy. It's from the Trio 99-2000 album with Bill Stewart and Larry Grenadier. Actually, I don't know if that was the first time it was recorded, but that's the one I probably listened to the most when it came out. And I was practicing yesterday or the day before and just started playing that melody out of nowhere. I've never played it before. Listened to it thousands upon thousands of times, which once again reconfirmed to me how important it is to be listening. And just whenever you're away from the instrument, you can still do purposeful practice. No bass, but a commute and tons of time and a pair of headphones, you can be practicing. And that is the fact that my ears got to the point where that kind of melody, that kind of phrase just comes out naturally now. Having literally never played that tune before is a testament to the fact that listening is super important. And the amount of time I put in away from the instrument these days actually eclipses the time with the instrument, just because there's so much other stuff going on with the baby and just with life in general. I don't get those 8, 9, 10 hours a day that I used to 20 years ago. So I really have to be purposeful with my time away from the bass that is almost always listening. And it was great that melody popped in to my playing and I slowed everything down. It's a boom, dee, da, ba, da, wah, oh. 1, 2, 3, 4. Is that kind of tempo somewhere like that on the record? As far as I remember, that's where I'm playing it. So I'm still working on it, still not 100% under the fingers. I didn't get the entire, all the intricacies of the melody didn't pop under my fingers yesterday when I was practicing, but the bare bones did. That made me go grab my Matheny songbook. This bad boy was a gift from my best friend, from Antonio. He even had Pat sign it. Somebody got it at a gig and waited in line. I had Pat sign it afterwards and gave it to me as a gift many, many years ago. Love this book. It inspired me to make my own songbook. Where is it? Almost as thick a volume. Look at that bad boy. There's a lot of information there. That's all the music from every album from the last 18 years of being a band leader and B flat parts and E flat parts and rhythm section. Holy shit. Okay, I gotta stay on track here. Get into this hour. I'm actually gonna use a timer. I rarely do this, but I'm gonna use a timer just to keep myself kind of disciplined a little bit. And for the purpose of the podcast, I was always going to practice regardless of the podcast. I just figured I would throw up the camera and let you guys in on the process. And maybe it would make for some interesting listening for some people who are interested in that kind of thing. So I'm going to get rid of the mic, no more talking, and get into this blues, and we'll see where it goes. I've been working on blues, like slow blues like this. The original key is actually C. I'm playing it in B flat right now, practicing playing it in 12 keys. So I might move around keys here and there, get into improvising, work on time and sound. I've been working on giant steps a lot recently, so I'll probably morph into that at some point in this hour. But let's see what happens.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, first pause for the chorus. As you can see, sort of all over the place a little bit. I was kind of sticking to playing the melody first. I'm still getting hung over up over that. Sometimes happens when I get over it, when I get into repetition over and over and over and over again, and then I get a little lost, like lose the focus. That's why it's good, at least for me, that's why it's good to practice something over and over and over again. So that kind of helps show me what I need to work on, and focus is definitely one of them. Let's see, I put a little loop in there, just played the whole melody over one chord, and then I was working on that pattern of 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, the pattern of 10. Trying to head to the one, like find the tension points. I kind of pick up that altered sound, that getting back to the one. So yeah, we'll get into some giant steps in a minute as well, I think.
Thank you. Thank you.
Getting up there. We're in the 30-minute range of practicing right now. Feels pretty good. Second break. Kind of morphed a little bit to giant steps here, as I'm sure you can hear. Just working on some connector. Going over, I've been trying to force myself to play some more repetitive stuff to put the very basics under the fingers and in the muscle memory a little better than I have before. I've got to say, until the last few weeks, I haven't really worked on this song that much, and I think it's because I was working on it as a song before rather than as the exercise, you know, kind of as it was intended, as I believe Coltrane wrote it as an exercise. And yeah, that's kind of been how I've been treating it, playing shapes and patterns and getting to know it a little better. Just being able to play that same thing because it happens in two different keys. That's basically the whole opening half. And then and trying to use the same phrase, because it's all just 2-5-1s after that. It's just 2-5 to E flat, 2-5 to G, 2-5 to B, 2-5 to E flat, and then 2-5. Classic Coltrane. Coltrane opening line of his solo. And then just being really in control of the placement of each 5 chord, being able to cop parts of the 2 chord. Those are all things I'm kind of working on the last couple of weeks. Definitely being able to take the flat 9 of the 5 chord everywhere. So B flat 7, flat 9. So B natural, going to 1. Same when we get to the next dominant chord of, and same again. And then, yeah, you guys probably all heard me. This is in one of my books. It's in the 251 book. I think it actually snuck into another book by mistake as well. I try never to repeat any of the information in the books, but it was really sort of super relevant to a 251 topic. Something I got from Michael Brecker many, many years ago. I'm sure he got it from probably Train or Dexter Gordon, but it's just 2-5, 2-5 shapes, and it works great. And the old honeysuckle rose lick. Always use down a 5 chord. And just all of those shapes that giving myself the discipline of having to, like, telling myself I've got to play it on each chord and stick into one set each time. Just for discipline. It's not particularly musical at all. It just gives me that repetition and that muscle memory to make sure I'm completely in control of it and that I can just hear it in the end. So I'm not thinking about whether it's a 2-5-1 or what key it's in or what notes I have to get to or what the target note is. It's just completely natural after this much repetition. And again, we're only talking about 30 minutes in so far, and it feels like a really solid practice session. It's had its ups and downs. I'm not going to get into all of them right now. This is part of my process. I record so much of what I do. I would have had the camera rolling anyway. Maybe not the 4K well-lit scene that you see here on YouTube if you're well, it's not that well lit actually, but you know, not the pro version that you're watching on YouTube if you are, not the pro audio if you're listening on just audio platforms for the podcast. Normally it's just in the phone, the voice recorder, or sometimes I'll throw the camera up if I'm trying to figure out something technical that I want to see. So normally I would be doing this anyway and then listening back to it again, away from the instrument, that really, like, dedicating the practice time away from the instrument when you can't be with it. If you've got an hour of your practice session, you know, while you're doing the dishes or going through the grocery store or in the car on a drive somewhere, you can be listening back and making mental notes like, oh, this is getting better, or I need to work more on that, and oh, it really wasn't. Again, we go back to the real versus feel. It really wasn't. The real wasn't what I was feeling in that moment. And you know, I did a lot of a cappella stuff with the melody, with the Pat Metheny melody, and it felt good at the time, in terms of the time. But I know I'm going to listen back, and there's going to be moments where I'm like, oh, I'm a little behind there, or I'm a little ahead, and just keep fine-tuning, keep listening, keep fine-tuning. That's the way forward. That's what I use all of this time, both with the instrument, recording these sessions, and away from the instrument for.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, so I just felt the usefulness start to dip away, and being that I've made good use of my time today already, this is, like I said, the third practice session of the day. This is a time when I will really be like, okay, I'm not going to force the issue. Maybe I'm really done. If I was only 20 minutes in and I started to feel that, I think I'd question it, or I would question it a lot more, and I'd give it another 3 or 4 minutes and see what came up, see if I was really just feeling stagnant and needed to stop, or whether I could kind of salvage more time, especially if I have it. It's really frustrating, as I'm sure you know. I'm sure you've been in that situation where it gets frustrating, where you actually have the time and then you really don't feel like it as much as you would perhaps like. And you really have to be feeling it to get the most out of it. Like, I felt really, really good over the course of the last hour. And I felt like I got to things that are coming back from previous practice sessions, which is always nice. There's a sense of progress. There's a sense of development, particularly motivically. And with certain shapes and phrases, I'm trying to be more fluent with. And also that pedal note, the dum, 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 that just that walking, not even a line, just a walking kind of note, a pulse, if you like. I haven't done that in a while. Just played against a single note, a single key center. And I felt really free. That is a very fun feeling when you feel totally loose and you can kind of go anywhere you want and rhythmic ideas are coming to you, and that's the feeling of a great practice session. So I'm super grateful that is the case today. That's how I'm feeling at this time. Now we're up around the 9:53 kind of zone. I think we've been running just about an hour now, so perfect timing. I'm not going to push it anymore. Not going to bash you over the head anymore with that, but that's it. That's a much longer form look inside what goes into almost an hour for me. few minutes shy of actually practicing for an hour because I talked a little bit up front of the podcast. But also, it's the third session of the day, so I'm totally fine with leaving it where it is. And I feel like I'm heading towards that goal, like I talked about on the last episode and how I've been talking about the last couple of weeks. I'm heading to that goal of being back in high, back with a high level of performance confidence by the time we hit the stage. It's now, by the time this podcast comes out, it will probably be less than a week to the show. But as I'm recording this, it's a week and a day until my next show. So I'm very conscious of that and giving the music as much respect as I possibly can in terms of being ready to go play music with those very high level musicians that I have a lot of respect for. So if you're in LA, January 5th will be the first gig of 2023 for me at the Baked Potato with Bob Reynolds, Ruslan Sirota, and Christian Heumann is playing drums. You may know him from Jacob Collier's band, and I've seen him with Kurt Elling before. He was outstanding. So I'm really looking forward to that. It'll be first time playing with Christian for me. So looking to see what he brings to the gig. If you're in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, February 2nd, we'll be out there with Bob Reynolds. February 2nd, I believe that's a Thursday night. So maybe we'll be missing our Baked Potato or pushing our Baked Potato for February back a week. We'll be out there in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. There will be details on my website soon if you're out that way. I don't think I have it up on my website yet. I don't think I actually know where the gig is yet, but it's in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Looking forward to that. It's a one-off with me, Bob Ruslan, and Gene. And I will be bringing you guys Yannick Wisdala Trio tour dates soon. Can't wait for that. But that's it. Let's call it an episode. And very, very happy with that. Really feeling like a great completion to the day. That's a great feeling. Go out there and strive for that if you can. And if you're not, again, I can't stress this enough. If you're not with your instrument, make sure you have some headphones with you. Make sure you are listening to music and that you are actively practicing away from your instrument. If you want to make those major gains and you want to rework what time you have available, don't forget to give credit to the rest of the day when you're away from the instrument and how much damage you can do, how much work you can put in, and how much that will seep into your playing without you even knowing it. So really, really fun way to work. So that's it. Thanks for listening if you made it this far, and catch you cats on the next one.